Eidolon, serve the Emperor's children during the Great Crusade, Horus Heresy, and Era Indomitus. A Terran by birth, Eidolon would be among the most senior ranks of the Third Legion, and bear the title of Lord Commander. Due to the Legion's ravaged numbers, during the loss of their gene stocks during the early days of the Great Crusade, the Third Legion would spend its initial years as a supplementary force under the supervision of the Lunar Wolves. With their recruits restoring the Legion's numbers, Eidolon would assist his Primarch, Fulgrim, in forming the ranks and command structure of the Legion. As the right hand of his Primarch, Eidolon would assist Fulgrim throughout the Great Crusade as a venerated yet pompous warrior. During the Legion's battles against the species of the planet of Leia, the corruption of the Emperor's children would begin. Their collective ego, bolstered by the influence of the Temple of the Lair and the discovery of the Blade within, Eidolon would be among the first to experiment with the bounty of riches the planet revealed. The Legion's chief apothecary, Fabius Bile, would discover the Lairan species had made extensive genetic alterations to their bodies. Eidolon, in his pursuit of power, would be among the first to be experimented on by Fabius aboard the void ship Andronius. Allowing his own men to be experimented on until Eidolon would deem Fabius's experiments to be safe for himself to undergo, the Lord Commander would begin his heretical surgeries. Following his recovery from the spider's knives, Eidolon would persecute the megarachnid species of the planet designated 1-4020, of which the so-called World of Murder had already claimed the lives of many Blood Angels Astartes. Alongside the Lunar Wolves, the Emperor's children, under the command of Eidolon, would lend their blades and bolters to the conflict. His methods of waging war and dubious commands, undermined by the Lunar Wolf captain, Tarek Torgadon, Eidolon's shame would further drive him to attain perfection. Hastening further augmentations to his body, Eidolon's trachea would be modified to increase the strength of his vocal cords. Utilizing such power during the compliance of the Istvan system alongside the 14th Legion, the Death Guard. His shrieks, capable of paralyzing and destroying the heretical Warsinger during battle. Further descending into madness following the betrayal of the Warmaster and his own traitor Primarch, Eidolon would aid in the purging of the loyalist elements of his Legion. Commanding his men during the Dropside Massacre of Istvan V, Eidolon would prove to be a fervent, if not capable, commander to his Primarch. Following Fulgrim's campaign to conquer the Forge World of Prismatica V, Eidolon would nonetheless overstep his Primarch's ever more fragile boundaries. Questioning Fulgrim's orders, the now angered Primarch would, in a paranoid stupor, behead the Lord Commander. His blood mixed with wine would be shared by the senior commanders of the Emperor's children, yet Eidolon would not remain dead for long. Ordering Chief Apothecary Fabius to restore the Lord Commander, Fulgrim would allow his right hand a chance at redemption. Sewing the grisly head back onto his body, Bile would reconnect the nerve clusters of Eidolon's neck and be imbued with the perverse favor of the Prince of Pleasure. Reborn, yet racked with unending pain, Eidolon would be driven mad with depraved joy. Referred to as the Risen, his unpleasantly scarred and horrific visage would serve as a reminder to the Emperor's children to never criticize their Primarch. Eidolon would remain a commander of the Legion and persecute the Loyalist forces during the Siege of Terra. Assaulting the Saturnine Gate alongside Abaddon the Despoiler, Eidolon would face the 7th Legion, the Imperial Fists. Dueling the Emperor's champion, Sigismund, Eidolon would be bested in combat and thrown from the battlements, plummeting 1,000 meters into the depths below. Yet despite his seeming death, the soul severed of the 3rd Legion still stalks the Imperium during the Era Indomitus. Styling himself as the Lord Commander Primus, Eidolon would attempt to reunify the Emperor's children. Allying once more with the now War Master of Chaos, Abaddon, Eidolon has been responsible for the sundering of hundreds of Imperial worlds. A champion of the Keeper of Secrets, Nakari, his Holy Inquisition has attempted to end the deeds of the Revenant Astartes to no avail. His flagrant defiance, an insult to not only the Imperium, but the sanctity of existence itself.